Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. It is Francesco here. Welcome to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. If you're brand new and if you're a regular, welcome back. So today's video is going to be dedicated to Wunderlist. We're going to be giving you a few alternatives to Wunderlist. So we'll be listing 10 today. So just before we dive in, make sure to hit that subscription button and the bell notification to get regular videos here on the Keep Productive YouTube channel. So guys, the first application is Todoist. Now Todoist is probably the most similar application when it comes to Wunderlist, Todoist comparisons. Although what I would say for those Wunderlist refugees is that Todoist is very much a more of an advanced application. You can do a lot more inside of the premium functions and in some extent some of the freemium functions. So if you are looking for an application to take you a little further, Todoist might be the resource for you. Number two is Any.DO. This is a very popular application and has a very strong retention rate with users. And it's really perfect because it has very similar features to Wunderlist, like theming, the ability to create and share lists, and also a very specific feature that allows you to process a task's individually called moments. So this is a great alternative, very simple, very easy to get on with, and that's Any.DO. So the third one is Remember the Milk. Very similar to Todoist in an extent, it is an advanced application. So if you're looking to take your sort of Wunderlist experience a little further, it's going to give you a lot more punch when you're using it. It is a web application, iOS and Android. Remember the Milk is a much older application, has been refreshed or has new fresh skin, which is fantastic. And it's a great resource if you're looking for a strong, more advanced application. So number four is ToDo. Now this is a much more advanced application from the likes of Todoist or Remember the Milk. It provides you with more of a GTD orientated experience. So if you're someone that is a bit more, you know, stricter on your productivity, then ToDo might be the upgrade that you need. It's available on Mac, iOS, and Android too now. It's a paid application, so you're gonna get a premium charge inside the application. So just be aware of that. But include pricing in description below, but it does give you a pretty rigid and tough experience once you're using it, especially on Mac. Number five is ToodleDo. I've got to do a full review on this one as of yet, but it is a very similar application to some extent to the likes of Todoist. It provides you with a pretty awesome, easy to get on with experience. It's less available on devices, but I'll include an inscription and is definitely a good alternative. Number six is Things3, and if you're an iOS and Mac lover, this is perfect for you. Things3 is a very simplistic application that provides such an elegant design. I gave this one the best design of 2017, just because it was clearly such a gorgeous application for Apple lovers. Now, if you're someone that just likes the sort of simplicity of Wunderlist without maybe the sort of like theming and colorizations and wants the ability to create projects and areas, this could be the resource for you. It's got a pretty hefty price. I think it's $49.99 for a one-off fee. But then again, you don't have to pay the recurring charges, but I'll include all of the pricing in the description below. So number seven, if you are looking for a very simple sort of iOS experience, it allows you to sort of tally up all of your items. It's very gesture-based, almost like Clear was in the old days. Sorted might be your resource. It's an iOS application. They're rolling out the third edition very, very soon, or it should be done by this video launch, but it will provide you with a nice hub to plot all of your tasks and use gestures to organize them to go into the right spot. So this is an application that's relatively new, but provides you with a really fluid experience. Number eight is TickTick. Now this, again, I would say, is probably alongside Todoist in the closest Wunderlist experience at the moment. With the themes and the advanced functionality, it does provide you pretty much a Wunderlist-like experience. It has risen since the likes of, you know, Wunderlist has been out, like announced that they are going away, and it's grown and grown just due to that factor. So it is something that is growing rapidly and a lot of people are thoroughly enjoying. Number nine is Microsoft ToDo. This is actually the application that Wunderlist is being replaced by, and they've got a ton of features. I've done a separate video on this one, what features are coming to it, that they are implementing that are very similar to Wunderlist. So you're actually gonna get a super similar experience, and the Wunderlist team themselves are going to be working on it. So I can see a lot of integration there. And finally, the final resource, which I don't recommend to everyone. This is more for those GTD lovers or someone who was in Wunderlist and going, okay, I've learned GTD, I've learned this process of doing things, and I'm like, I want to take it to the next level. OmniFocus 2 could be the resource for you. It's only available on macOS and iOS, so it's going to be a bit restricted, but it might take you to the next level of your productivity. Now, if you want to make the investment, it is pretty pricey, but it does a really good job. And just to note, I'll include all of the links and everything like that in the description below. Anyway, guys, those are a few of the best Wunderlist alternatives. I'll probably be doing a longer piece on the Keep Productive website. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for stopping by. I really appreciate your love today. Make sure to hit the subscription button and the bell notification to get regular updates on the video. And if you liked this video, make sure to hit that like button below. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for stopping by. Make sure to have a great week, keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.